Hello and welcome back to LDCFM. You're tuning into our podcast featuring interviews with our community of independent designers and industry guests. We'll be discussing topics of sustainability, conscious design, the future of fashion, tech, and innovation. This podcast has been recorded alongside an Instagram Live, so apologies for any technical issues prior to tuning in. Thank you for listening.
Everybody, it's Alice from Lone Design Club. Welcome back to our IG Live schedule. I'm coming to you live from the back of our King's Road unit in Chelsea. And we'll be joined by one of the designers of one of our brands, Chirica of LYL. Before we start, just a reminder that we do these lives all the time and we thank you all for tuning in. And as always, if you have any questions at all, just write them in the comments and we will answer them for you throughout the live. If not, and you just don't feel confident putting them in the comments or you want to ask them at a later date, please just DM. We're more than happy to answer them. We would like to say a little bit of what we're wearing, and I am wearing some very cute Alison Fern earrings, which you can find at linedesignclub.com. We will have no lives this weekend, but we will be bringing loads of content from the stores, and on Monday, Rebecca will be going live with Kevin Raven. So, without further ado, I'm going to welcome Chirica to join me, and we're going to start the conversation.
If you want to ask them at a later date, please just DM, we're more than happy to answer them. We would like to say a little bit of wearing, and I am wearing some very cute Alison Fern earrings.
Hello. Hi there. Hi, Alice. How are you?
I'm great, thanks. How are you?
I'm really hot. Good.
Yes. I am like seeing how shiny I look on the screen. I'm like, okay. Yeah. Shame you can't put filters. Oh, I think you can. I probably just don't know how to do that. Well, thank you so much for joining us on this very warm Friday afternoon. We have now been working with you for a few months, so it's a pleasure to have you doing a live. Great to get everyone to know a little bit more about yourself and the story behind the brand and how it all started. So we've got some great questions lined up, and we'll just be having a wonderful discussion, hopefully. And if anyone in the audience who's watching has any questions, please just let us know, and we'll give them an answer when there's a perfect moment in the conversation. So, Chirica, start off by telling us about yourself and your background, and how that led you to start LYL.
Sure. I am the founder and CEO of LYL, which is a women's workwear fashion brand. It's more of a modern take on power dressing. My background is I spent over 10 years working in finance, which is very different to fashion. Very keen on making sure that there was more clothing options for women in my journey and my experience. I literally launched LYL last year in October. We've been growing ever since, which is great news. It was a real shift from finance, working in the city, to building a fashion brand. Yeah, and creating clothing and a whole different industry. But I enjoyed learning about it. I enjoyed learning about ethically producing clothing. I learned about the construction of fabric and how to make something look a certain way. So for me, I'm happiest when I'm learning. And the whole of last year, even now, I'm learning about it. I'm always picking up things out. And that's actually how LYL came about.
So why LYL? What does LYL mean?
So LYL stands for Love Your Look, and the brand is all about female empowerment, and it's about being confident. Feeling confident, feeling empowered. So my basis of starting it was that when I worked in the city, I was often the only woman in the room, I was at a very senior level. Only woman in the room, only black woman in the room, so many only women that kind of context. So I always used fashion to stand out. I used to watch shows like Suits and Scandal with all these incredible women. You see what I mean? These incredible women, like from, you know, all these different characters, like Donna and Jessica Pearson and Olivia Pope, sort of incredible women. Yes.
Her wardrobe is gold.
Yeah. Everything about her wardrobe. Exactly. So you've got to be, and I loved it. So you've got to be, like, badasses. They're so incredible and inspiring they are. But then I looked at clothing options, and when I looked in the shop, yes, there was clothing, but it wasn't the same kind of standard of quality and what you see produced. Or when I did find it, it was extremely high end, and not everybody wants to spend £5,000 on a blazer, for example. So the style, yes, so the style aesthetic, that kind of woman, I had her in mind when I was building the collection and designing. So, yeah, that's literally where it came from. I felt there was a need for more options for women, especially when we're saying we want to see more women in the workplace and more women in the boardroom. And we have to set, you know, examples of that through the clothing options available too. So, yes.
And that's why it was a perfect fit of professional women's.
Yes, it was.
Edward Mongs and Art. Hey guys, hey Edward Mongs and Art. They say we absolutely love your designs at LOL.
Thank you.
Such great work there. So thanks, guys. Yeah, I totally agree. So are you wearing something from LOL right now?
I am.
Tell us a bit about the piece you're wearing.
Yeah, so I'm wearing the cocoa shirt. It's a classic white shirt staple. We wanted something for the workplace with a bit of flair. So if you can see, there's a bit of detail here on the shoulders here.
Yeah.
And the sleeves are also ballooned. So it's just something different for workwear. So we know that, generally speaking, in work environments, not just work environments, because I've, you know, you've read them on the weekend too. But we wanted something that had a bit more of a statement effect to it as well. And often, people have bought our products with models of different events, not just for the office. And it's versatile like that. So when we create a white shirt, we don't want it to be the typical white shirt that you get everywhere. It's got to be a bit different. The fabric is weighted, it holds structure really, really well, and that's one of the things that we love about our design. We try and make things quite unique and develop them.
Yeah, that's true. It's very versatile. Julio and I styled it with just like blue jeans in March. You can definitely wear it that way as well. You can't go wrong with like a perfect white shirt. So. And I'm accidentally wearing white today as well, so we're matching.
It's good.
Yeah. So you mentioned materials. So obviously a lot of what we talk about at LDC is sort of sustainability and production. You know, obviously now is a time when starting a brand, it's almost impossible to not think about those elements. Because it's so talked about and there's so much more information out there compared to years ago. Mm-hmm. So how does that factor into your brand? How does that factor into the processes that you use, the materials you use, the people you work with?
Yes.
Sorry, that's a lot of questions. Yes.
No, I'm telling you. So I think what I'm really happy about is that sustainability is not just a trend. It's something that is here to stay. And even during this whole lockdown period, we're seeing how, you know, pollution has dropped. And the earth is basically healing itself in so many new ways, and that is the big pro of everyone being at home, right? So when I created the brand, I wanted it to be a brand that was ethical. I wanted it to be made correctly in terms of production. As I said, I'm not someone that produces clothing myself, but I've partnered with factories that are ethical, that produce things in the right way. We do small limited edition runs, and we avoid waste. That's all aspects of the process, because obviously for a new brand, any waste is also losing money too. So we're very keen to make sure we're tight on things. We are even thinking about things for the future. So currently, all of our packaging is plastic free. We do not use plastic at all. We want all the goods to be recyclable, so that, you know, we're not just contributing to things and making the earth of, you know, worse. So that is always at the forefront of our mind. But even going forward, with the fabrics we're using, we're looking into recyclable polyester fabrics that are being developed. What we're finding is that the industry is actually moving along as we're moving along. So you're getting more and more options. And the hope is that soon we'll be able to actually produce things that are made out of recyclable fabrics too. But for now, we use limited edition runs, small quantities, we avoid wastage as much as possible. And I think also what's empowering is that we often use factories that focus on women. We've been to the factories, we've met the women that make the clothing, we know that they're in good conditions and they're paid fairly. So that is really important to us, because I feel like business often can be used to exploit people. And I don't believe it has to be that way. I think people can use it as an opportunity to create wealth for the company, but also for all the supply chain. So our factories are our partners. They are who we work with. They don't make the clothing we want them to sell. So it really is about strengthening those bonds and really being keen to build the right relationship and build the ethics of your brand. It shouldn't just be a trend it should be actually at the heart of your brand and how you feel about the clothing that you're wearing.
Yeah, I totally agree.
And very difficult. You know, obviously, it's been a very difficult. It really has shone.
In some ways, silver lining, I suppose, for people who do care about people and the planet.
This has shed some serious light on some of the issues.
Yes.
You know, they were there before, we were already talking about it, but now this has escalated the process. I'm hoping that this means going forward. Greater emphasis on independent, sustainable brands, instead of constantly supporting the big guys who aren't really trying to change their habits because they don't have to, and I think focusing on the smaller brands will really hopefully start to make a difference. We've had a couple of questions, so we have another one from Ed. What is the biggest difference and biggest similarity between fashion and finance? Do you feel more free doing fashion? And then we just had a lovely comment from Ozzy Australis saying, supply chain prosperity is environmentally friendly.
So what are your thoughts on Ed's question?
So I think that fashion is very different to finance.
So I was a manager for banks, right? Couldn't be further apart. I worked for all the big boys in terms of the banks. I worked on internal strategy of how to improve things. And while that's very different, we're not talking about tangible products in the same way we're talking about money, right? We're talking about products that are services, but they're also an intangible product. We know that they're related to mortgage, corporate mortgage, any type of product that's related to finance, but I think the strategic element of it and the way that you approach problems in terms of finance is very much a correlation to fashion because a business is a business, and while we are core on the fixed and the construction of garments etc and product labor, there's a lot of the business elements that you have to apply in the finance area, albeit very different, right? So it's more about knowing how to use your skill set and adapt to fashion. And I've had to actively learn so much about the fashion industry because I frankly didn't know before. I had to learn that to make clothing, I have to get a patent made. There's so many factors to it that I haven't ever done before. So it's free in a lot of senses because I'm actually doing something that I really enjoy. But in other senses, for a little while, particularly when we were starting out before we launched, there was so much learning to happen there. Sometimes felt quite overwhelming. But it was good knowing that we're building something that's brand new. And I found that quite liberating. So yes, I'd say there's a lot of freedom in it, but there's also, in terms of the business of fashion, there's a lot of parallels in terms of the thinking behind it.
Okay, amazing. Sorry, I will be back in one second. But if you want to talk to everyone about what you want the customer to feel when they wear your clothes, that would be amazing. And any top styling tips, sorry.
Of course, no problem. Okay, so in terms of the brand LYL, we are all about female empowerment. So obviously when customers buy our clothing, we want them to love the fit of it, not to love the product itself. But we also really want them to feel empowered. We want them to feel confident, and we believe that that's what our products do when they wear them. So that's a big thing for us. In terms of styling tips, I would say don't be afraid of colour. I think there's so much beautiful tones and shades that we can wear. Whether it be a bright yellow or a nice plum, like, there's so many different colours to be worn. Days are gone where you have to just wear black or grey or dark blue. You can wear so many other colours. So I really love that about what's, you know, happening now, particularly in the workwear space. There's a lot more colours being used.
There's a lot more colours being used. That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, so those are our general styling tips. And I also think that when it comes to styling your clothing, don't be afraid to accessorize. There's so many opportunities to change your look, change a whole outfit just by adding a different bag or a belt or, you know, a pair of shoes, a nice pair of heels. Hi there. Thanks for joining. Yeah, there's so many ways to diversify your wardrobe by accessorizing. I feel like when we're moving towards more sustainable approaches to fashion, it is about buying staple pieces that can last a long time that are really, really well made too. So, it's an exciting time. Had a question come through. Do you feel that you have to educate consumers while caring for social and environmental impact in your company? I think it's good to. I think it's good to educate, because I think that nowadays, especially as an independent brand, you want to be more than just a business that sells fashion, you know, that sells clothing. I think it is good to say why you're here and to talk about yourself, because that's basically how you stand out. That's how you position yourself as an independent brand. So I think it is important to educate, but also to tell your story, whatever that is. There's always power in a story. At the end of the day, when you buy products, you're not just buying from the business, you're buying from people that made your business, that have contributed to make your actual product. So I think educating and talking about your brand is important. I think that is important. Any more questions? Send them through. I'm ready. Good stuff.
Sorry, Cherica.
Can we pick this up in two minutes?
I completely closed the door, but I forgot to lock it. So I will be back in 1 second. Okay. I'm so sorry. but keep answering questions. Did you want me to take your details? Are you sure? Okay, sorry about that.
So, question come through. How do you choose your textile partners? So, what I've done, it's actually quite interesting. When I started the brand last year, October, before that, I was literally trying to figure out how you find textiles, how do you find fabrics. As I mentioned, I worked in finance before, so I had no idea how you start looking for fabrics or start looking for factories. What I did do, which was helpful for me, was go to trade shows in the UK. So one of them was Fashion SUP, which you may have heard of. But there's also others like Pure London, where you can go there and find out about garments, find out about fabrics, etc. So when I went to Fashion SVP, I met a lady that specialised in producing garments for small runs, which is exactly what we wanted to do with the brand. So I spoke to her, we had a few conversations, she was based in Eastern Europe, and I started to research more about, okay, where do other places get products made? I actually looked at our competition in terms of workwear, because different countries are known for different things when it comes to manufacturing, and where I wanted to go to needed to be somewhere that's focusing on workwear that could do it for smaller runs and smaller quantities. So I kept in contact with a lady that I met at Fashion SVP, and then I emailed her, and then eventually I went to visit in April of last year. And when I went there, I started to see a lot of fabrics that I liked, and they were all there, particularly the ones that I found that I was interested in.
Fantastic. And apologies again, everyone. I'm in the back of one of our stores doing this live, and I closed the door. I thought I'd locked it, and then a woman walked in, and she didn't seem to understand that I wasn't open.
Okay.
Anyway, I'm really sorry about that. And yeah, so that was, I was just worried about letting her walk around because she didn't seem to understand that we weren't open.
Okay.
Sorry about that, but I'm back and I've locked the door. So obviously you mentioned something at the start of when we were talking about your past career
in that, you know, one of the things that sort of stood out to you was that, you know, not only were you one of the women in the room, but you were also one of the only black women in the room.
Mm-hmm. So obviously not only 2020 has been a really big year in terms of things, health, social politics, environment, there's been a lot going on in the last few months, and that I think is probably changing the world for the better.
Yeah.
And as a black-owned business and as a female-owned business, you know, have you noticed any changes or experienced anything in terms of the fashion industry since Black Lives Matter came to the forefront of people's attention again recently? Have you noticed a shift in your life or your business?
Yeah, so I think there's more awareness.
It's so sad that something so terrible has to happen to
awareness. Because obviously, as a member of the black community,
I've known about different
mentalities,
whether it's in the UK or in America.
I can't escape it as a black woman.
I've only been in the fashion industry for
18 months to 2 years. So I've not been in the fashion industry long enough to talk about how I've experienced it within the fashion space, but definitely in the corporate.
The fact that I was the only senior person of colour, it speaks for itself.
But I think the good thing is that conversations are being had. We're now in a position where we can talk about injustices that we've felt, whether it's systematic racism and how we can actually deal with it collectively, because it's not a black issue, it's something that the whole world needs to address. And I'm glad that, you know, my friends that are white or Asian have spoken to me about different things, and we've been having this kind of conversation before. I think no one really wants to talk about race for fear of being labelled as a racist or things like that, and it really didn't help the conversation to move forward, but now we're having those conversations, because the statistics actually speak for themselves. If we look into systematic racism, we can see it in statistics, so we know that a black-owned business is two times as likely to be denied loans for the business, for example. We know that when it comes to funding for venture capitalism, black women get 0.5%, not even up.
I think the conversations need to happen first, I suppose. Like you said, maybe people didn't
Okay, what's going on with the connection? Thank you. I don't know what's going on with the connection. Can you, are you still there? What's going on here? Is it coming back? Okay, I want to try and log back on here. I don't know if it's working. Okay. Oh dear. Hello? Hi. I'm your best to join.
Quality. And that integrity with what we're building. We don't.
Okay.
The actual corporations to work with them, etc. So there's so much more that we have in store. And we're excited. Sorry, everybody, my phone overheated and died. That's not what it is today. I can only apologize. Really sorry about that. It would appear that.
Hello. We're back on.
my phone overheated and decided to die.
Yeah. I think my phone's close as well. It's very hot.
It's but very hot and it was like 30.
Yeah.
It's hot. So sorry about that. Apparently, it's just one of those days where we are going to be interrupted. But we were sort of getting to the end anyway.
Yes,
but,
yes.
You know, it sounds like you've got some exciting things, and like I was great, and we hope to see more of it. One last question for you I have is, and it might be wearing, but what is your favourite piece from your collection?
I would say our Madame dress. It's currently out in ivory. It's a midi dress. It's very classic, very elegant, very chic. It reminds me a lot of the kind of 1950s styles. And we're about to release it in more colours too, but it's such a classic piece. And it's so, when you wear it, you just feel good. You feel like $1 million, you feel really good. And I love that piece. That's one of my favourites. So I'd say that one. But I wear this Coco shirt all the time, literally for any reason.
That's a very, you can wear that all the time.
Literally.
I liked that shirt as well. I think that was probably my favourite one because of its versatility Okay, fantastic. Well, I feel like we got quite a lot of good questions, which is always good on the side.
If anyone
has burning questions and they haven't had the ground to ask them, you can just DM us, or if you missed this, it will be on IGTV, so you can watch it, and we will also be recorded it, so it will go on our podcast. It's all very exciting stuff, and you've not missed out at all. And you can drop our way out on Motors Line Club, which is great. Do not hesitate to get in contact with myself or Cherica about anything we discussed today. More than happy to answer. And in the meantime, I really hope that you guys, and especially you, Cherica, have lovely, sunny, hot afternoon that your phone does not open.
Yes.
Although that's good, take a break from the phone.
Yes.
And that you have a pretty lovely weekend. And thank you so, so much for joining us.
Thank you for inviting me on. It's really nice to be here. And thank you for the support with the brand as well. You guys are fantastic. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Hopefully we'll see you soon in the flesh.
Yes. All right. Take care.
Okay. Thank you, everyone.
Bye. Thank you.
Day.
Bye.
Thank you so much again for tuning in. Head to our website loanedesignclub.com and find more LDCFM podcasts, or discover more about our independent designers online.